10 strongest ocean creatures that ever lived. With all the gigantic and powerful aquatic animals that exist, the ocean is a scary place to go swimming. And present day is the least scary the ocean has ever been. You wouldn't want to set one toe in the water back in the day. Some of today's big beasts of the sea couldn't even hold a candle to the marine animals that roamed the oceans years and years ago. We're going to compare today's heavy hitters to the big boys of days past and give you the 10 strongest ocean creatures that ever lived. You might be surprised how some of today's ocean creatures stack up. Before we get into the first animal on our list, we'd like to give an honorable mention to the great white shark. The great white shark is the most feared, most brutal shark in the world today. He is the biggest shark alive today, with the strongest bite force of any shark today, but he just narrowly misses the list. How is that? Orca. For starters, the great white shark misses the list because there is the orca, also known as the killer whale. That name isn't just a name, it has specific meaning. When measuring bite force of animals alive today, scientists can get exact readings and approximate readings. Of the exact readings, the Nile crocodile has the strongest bite force of 5,000 pounds per square inch. The great white shark is second with 4,000 psi. Couple that with its average length of about 15 feet long and the fact that it can reach up to 4,000 pounds, it's a killer. But orcas are great white killers. They're killer whales. Orcas often reach up to 25 feet long. They can weigh in at 8,000 pounds. They're 10 feet longer than a great white, twice the weight and pure muscle. Oh, and an orca's bite force? It isn't one that scientists ever get an exact reading on, only an approximate reading. But they are fairly certain of their approximate reading, and it is scary, because that reading is 19,000 psi. Yes, nearly 5 times that of a great white shark's, and 4 times that of the next closest animal. Regardless of whether you believe it is accurate or not, it doesn't matter. The orca doesn't care what you think. Remember we said they are great white killers? That was no hyperbole. Killer whales have been known to hunt and kill great whites. The great white may be the largest and strongest shark alive, but the killer whale is the largest and strongest predatory animal alive. It doesn't just beat the great white in that category, it eats the great white. Tylosaurus. If you live in England or New England and love going in the ocean, do not, we repeat, do not ever time travel back to the late Cretaceous period. That is when Tylosaurus dominated the North Atlantic waters. Fossils of Tylosaurus have been found primarily in North America, Europe, and some in Africa. Tylosaurus lived during the Turonian to Maastrichtian stages of the late Cretaceous, 92 million to 69 million years ago. We're quite lucky we missed him by a few dozen million years, because he was scary. Tylosaurus was a monosaur. In fact, he was the second biggest one. Monosaurs were predatory marine lizards, which coincidentally are the last 3 words you want to hear while you're floating in the water of the deep ocean. Tylosaurus usually grew to lengths of somewhere between 25 to 40 feet long, and some were even 45 feet long. Pair that with this fact. On each side of the skull, Tylosaurus had 2 premaxillary teeth, 12 to 13 maxillary teeth, 13 dentary teeth, and 10 to 11 pterygoid teeth. Each side, that's a lot of teeth. No wonder why this successful hunter lived for over 25 million years. Cretoxyrhina. Next, we have another marine animal that had some overlap with Tylosaurus. This is Cretoxyrhina. Cretoxyrhina lived between 107 to 73 million years ago, between the mid to late Cretaceous period. Cretoxyrhina is also referred to as the Ginsu shark, thanks to its primary feeding mechanism being compared to the slicing and dicing of a Ginsu knife. Our Ginsu shark was comparable in size and build to the current great white, but they did oftentimes get bigger, approaching 25 feet long. Smaller than Tylosaurus though, right? Sure, but Ginsu sharks often ate Tylosauruses. Yes, they ate the gigantic Tylosaurus, as well as other sharks, large fish, pliosaurs, and get this, they occasionally ate dinosaurs and pterosaurs. Meaning these ocean creatures were also predators of animals on the land and in the air. Was nowhere safe from Cretoxyrhina. Their teeth were over 3 inches long, built with thick enamel, and were razor sharp, so they could stab and slice their prey. If that wasn't enough, they're estimated to be one of the fastest swimming sharks, able to hit bursts of 43 miles per hour. They were apex predators of their time, one of the largest sharks in their time period, and one of the largest sharks ever. That time period must have been so difficult for poor Tylosaurus. At least the Ginsu sharks went extinct about 73 million years ago, giving Tylosaurus a nice, quiet 7 million year span without them. Mosasaurus. Tylosaurus was the second largest mosasaur ever. The largest was simply named Mosasaurus. Mosasaurus had a slightly shorter time span of his existence, from about 82 million years ago to 66 million years ago. He also lived during the Cretaceous period, but he would have been a bully to Tylosaurus. Mosasaurus averaged 45 feet long, and the largest ones were around 56 feet long, and they weighed in the neighborhood of 22,000 pounds. Actually, if you took every house in the neighborhood and stacked them on top of one another, that's about the weight of Mosasaurus. Do you remember the gigantic ocean creature in the tank of the 2015 movie Jurassic World? That was Mosasaurus. Mosasaurus was first discovered by humans in the late 18th century. Skulls of theirs were discovered in a chalk quarry near the Dutch city of Maastricht. No one knew what they were. They thought it belonged to a crocodile or a whale, and it was later discovered that this was the largest mosasaur in the world, one of the largest and most powerful creatures the ocean ever housed. Otodus. A little more recently, we have another gigantic shark, even bigger than the Ginsu shark. This was Otodus, which is Greek for inclined teeth or ear-shaped tooth. Otodus lived between 60 to 45 million years ago, during the Paleocene-Eocene period. Otodus was usually 30 feet in length and sometimes even exceeded that. So yes, bigger than a great white, bigger than the Ginsu shark, bigger than an orca. Not only were they massive, their teeth were more than 4 inches long. Sounds like a dentist's worst nightmare. Otodus was a strong predatory shark, hunting fish, turtles, sirenids, and whales. Due to the placement of bite marks, it was learned that Otodus went for the skull when it attacked, attempting to deliver an immediate and fatal blow. Its teeth would not only go through the skull of its prey. In the case of a sperm whale that fell prey and was studied, Otodus's jaws would sink all the way through and even leave marks on the teeth of its prey. That's a powerful bite. Basilosaurus. Our next powerful ocean creature has had an interesting journey. It is Basilosaurus and lived even more recently than some of the others, from about 41.3 to 33.9 million years ago in the late Eocene period. When Basilosaurus was first discovered, scientists believe it to be a giant reptile. That is why it was named as it was, with the suffix saurus, which is ancient Greek for lizard. But Basilosaurus was not like Tylosaurus or Tyrannosaurus, no. Basilosaurus was actually a large predatory whale. But its skull was so similar to that of Mosasaurus that it was originally thought to be related. But Basilosaurus was actually a marine mammal, one of the largest animals of its time, one of the largest whales to ever exist, and a top predator in its time. It not only preyed on fish and other marine mammals, it even preyed on sharks. Basilosaurus was about 60 to 70 feet long and had a strange, long, snake-like body, sometimes compared to that of a gigantic eel. It was first discovered in 1834 and was the first prehistoric whale known to science. Fossils have since been found in Peru and southeastern United States, specifically Alabama, where scientists were able to learn most of what we know about it today. But fossils have also been unearthed in places like Morocco, Egypt, Tunisia, and Pakistan. It sure sounds like Basilosaurus was quite the journeyman. Helicoprion. We're going to go back even further to discover one of the largest sharks to ever exist, Helicoprion, living 290 to 250 million years ago, from the early Permian to the middle Permian periods. The Helicoprion not only was a massive danger to others, but it had quite the mechanical sounding name, didn't it? That's for good reason. Helicoprion is Greek for spiral saw. It was named this because it had coils of teeth that lined its jaws, and the coils either unfurled or they spun like a table saw in order to crush their prey. Sounds like an evil invention, huh? In addition to that maniacal form of killing prey, Helicoprion also grew to 30 feet long, and sometimes exceeded that. It weighed right around 1,000 pounds, and it was an extremely muscular and powerful shark. Even scarier than knowing it dominated its time period and whatever region it inhabited is knowing it inhabited many regions. Remains have been found in Russia, China, Australia, Kazakhstan, Japan, Norway, Mexico, the US, and plenty more places. No one was safe from the table saw jaw. Tychodus. Another one of the largest sharks to ever exist was Tychodus. The last shark was the spiral saw, but Tychodus is Greek for another unique name, folded teeth. Tychodus lived between 90 and 60 million years ago, during the late Cretaceous and early Paleogene periods. Now, Tychodus had large, flat teeth unlike many other sharks of that time, and fed primarily on shellfish he found on the ocean floor. But he often exceeded lengths of 30 feet long and weighed anywhere between 1,000 and 2,000 pounds. When Tychodus needed to throw his weight around, he was a strong individual. Much of the remains of Tychodus that humans have found have been where the Western Interior Seaway would have been present, which was an ancient sea that split North America into two landmasses, right about where the Rocky Mountains are, for around 34 million years. Perhaps the Rocky Mountains should be a little better known for their shellfish-eating giant sharks. Blue whale. Let's jump way ahead in the timeline, all the way to present day. Meet the blue whale. You're likely well aware of his exploits. Largest animal living today. The blue whale easily measures 90 feet long, and most times is 100 feet or longer, and they weigh between 290,000 pounds to 330,000 pounds. The blue whale is not only the largest living animal, it is the largest animal to have ever lived. With that size comes great jaw-dropping, oh my goodness, raw power. The blue whale doesn't quite rely on its bite, so relative to its size, its bite force isn't extraordinary. But if you just look at the numbers on their face, the blue whale has a bite force of approximately 19,000 psi, same as the orca. It doesn't matter if the blue whale is much bigger, that bite would still hurt. That's about 13 times the world's deadlift record. The blue whale is not only a massive animal, even its body parts are massive. Its heart weighs as much as a gorilla, and its tongue weighs as much as an elephant. Don't let blue lick you, he might kill you. Megalodon. Our list wouldn't be complete without the undisputed king of the ocean, Megalodon. Living fairly recently, from 23 to just 3.6 million years ago, Megalodon existed from the early Miocene to the Pliocene periods. You should feel lucky you weren't alive 3.6 million years ago. The Megalodon was the largest shark ever to live. You walk through the woods, and you're scared of seeing Bigfoot. Well, Megalodon is Greek for big tooth, and those teeth should have struck fear in your heart. His robust teeth were 7 inches long, built to grab prey and shatter bones. We've talked a lot about bite force. We mentioned the great white as a bite force of 4,000 psi. We didn't mention T-Rex, king of the dinosaurs. His was about 8,000 psi. Orcas and blue whales have a bite force of 19,000 psi. But no one comes close to Megalodon. His bite was estimated at 40,000 psi, more than twice his nearest competitor and 10 times the strength of a great white. Megalodon is a distant relative of the great white, similarly built but stockier. They were easily over 35 feet long, oftentimes between 40 and 50 feet long, and the largest megalodons would have reached 67 feet long. They would have weighed over 120,000 pounds. Megalodon was, fins down, the most powerful predator the oceans ever saw, with the strongest bite force of any animal ever. You might wonder who were the unluckiest inhabitants to coexist with Megalodon. Where did Megalodon live? Megalodon fossils have been found on every continent besides Antarctica.